Alright, before we get into this video, I want to give a disclaimer. Now, I live around this area where the setting of this movie takes place. It's no less than a 3-hour drive, so I'm not blind at all to what happens down on the Wind River Reservation. And this doesn't just happen on the Wind River Reservation. It happens to all reservations in the United States and Canada. Now, these lands are almost like third world countries. The poverty on these reservations are extremely high. Crime is high. Drug use is high. Alcoholism is high, domestic abuse is high, and the movie that does a really good job at showing that is the film Wind River. Now, not everything is as bad on the real life Wind River Reservation as they are in the movie. I know some really good people down there, and I have even made some good friends from the Wind River Reservation. This movie really just highlights the negative, the bad, and the ugly, and it does a pretty good job at it, showing the effects and the results of sending the defeated Native Americans to these sovereign lands. A point made quite regularly in this film is the geographical disadvantages of the Wind River Reservation. A perfect example of this is in the scene where Jane Banner shoots down one of the addicts. Jane tells the officer that he's still alive and that they need to call EMS. The officer says that EMS is an hour away and that by the time EMS gets there, he'll already be dead. This isn't the only instance of the geographical disadvantages in this movie. But why are there so many reservations that don't have good support when stuff like this happens? Well, when the US and Canadian governments started moving Indigenous people to reserves, these lands were not rich with great farming soil or filled with wildlife and a prosperous environment. No, these reservations were on shit land. Land that to this day doesn't look good. My favorite shot in this movie is where Corey is driving down the road and the camera shows us what is around him in his environment. Then we get the shot of some locals making a fire, and then the camera pans up, to which we see an upside down American flag. Now, the symbolism of the upside down flag is not meant to say the US sucks. No, the upside down flag is a call for help. Taylor Sheridan did not mean for the upside down flag to be offensive. According to the US flag code, the American flag should never be displayed upside down, except as a signal of dire distress in instances of extreme danger to life or property. This call for help isn't something shallow like whining to the government that they don't give you enough money. But there's one thing I haven't mentioned, and it's basically the whole body of the movie, the MMIW. Or the missing and murdered Indigenous women. This issue doesn't just affect Native women in the US, but also in Canada as well. And the reason I haven't talked about it is because I'm afraid this is a symptom of the overall problem. Don't get me wrong, yes, this is an issue, but it's merely a symptom of the overarching mess. The Native Americans aren't putting the flag upside down to be disrespectful, they are doing it because they need help, and I'm afraid that help might never come. There's a reason that this doesn't get as much news coverage as Will Smith slapping Chris Rock. There's a reason why this is probably the first time you're hearing about this problem. And it's mostly because the governments just don't care. In the movie, all that Natalie gets from the law enforcement to get her justice is a single FBI agent that happened to be close by. I don't know the solution to the overbearing mess, and I am not sure if there are any. This is a human crisis that is like an open secret. Everyone might know the problem, but what do you do about it? As technology advances and society moves into virtual reality, the chances of the high rates of drug use, crime, and violence being solved and everyone on these reservations being 100% happy is slowly dissipating into thin air. Wind River doesn't just show the negatives, the bad, and the ugly of these Native American reservations. It uncovers the harsh reality.